it's always been like an old friend. Yeah. See the sunshine like fine wine. Warm summer days take me away like an old friend coming home, dreaming my time away for sunshine.
Forever that I remember you sober. the birth of a model town. William Davidovich, Roy Barker, and John Forrester formed a partnership with a gentleman's agreement, a shake of the hand. It was July 1953 when this ecstatic trio staked and recorded their claims on the shore of Lake Manitouwadge. Base metal was found. The rush was on.
Hey fellas, could I fly you all the way up here just to watch Roy chop up some dirty old rock?
Why don't you just stick to flying planes and selling cars there, John? Because if this is what I think it is, you'll be able to get a new plane, and then we might survive our next trip out here.
Well, there's no doubt about what we're standing on here, guys. I can see it now. A town nestled on Lake Manitouwadge. We're in this together, guys. I want to introduce to you the people that are on the stage with me here tonight. Some of you probably know these guys. I got to start with the top of the seniority list. Bobby DeBroy. Came to Manitouwadge in 1957. Hung around for a little bit, left, came back in 61, has been here ever since. Glenn Keenan, 1977 he came here. Raising his family here.
Oh yeah. And this other guy who's doing all the talking, that's, you all probably know him, that's Ed Henderson. Ed wasn't born here, but he just wishes he was, and he's been here since, for sure.
I moved here in 1965. Left for 6 years, realized just how life is outside of this community, and I come right back.
And we're going to do a song about this. We wrote a song just for this occasion about all the people that got dropped off at the corner of Highway 17 and the 614.
Well, go up a little higher.
And because I'm sure there were plenty of people, this fella Taz right here beside me, he was one of them, got dropped off at the corner. And some poor bugger gave him a ride into town, and he's been here since.
23 years!
But anyway, we wrote this song. We're going to have Andre Paquette joining us on lead guitar. Crank her up, Andre. And Taz on the harp. The song is called The Corner. When the brakes come on and the bus driver said, we're here. It's been 1,000 miles, seems like a year, as I looked around for my gear. When I looked out through these foggy eyes and what did just appear? Well, nothing, simply nothing. What the hell am I doing here? Sweet dreams of times and to go back home, kiss me while I'm away, it's here. It's been a lot of years and a good few, as I looked in through the rear. When I looked out through these clearing eyes and what did just appear? Well, nothing, simply nothing. And what the hell am I doing here? Take your voice. Know that sea. Well, I looked at through the sucker boat and the hunt on a road. When I looked at through and the light hit the road, and he's heading into town. When I looked into those starry eyes and what did just appear? Ooh, loving, yes, they loving, and I'm so damn glad to be here.
Chassant le fils du roi. un méchant. Au fils du roi, tu es méchant. Que crois-tu, mais mon canon blanc.
Canoe Club, we're really pleased to start the Manitouwadge. Hopefully it's their first annual Dragon Boat Festival. It's really important that we have this kind of turnout. By the turnout here, the weather, it's going to be a fantastic event. I'd like to bring to your attention that every festival, normally there's a tradition that goes with it. It's called the Awakening of the Dragon. Hundreds of years ago, before we were born in this small village in China, there was a poet, a very famous poet, that performed a very heroic deed which cost his life. And in honor of that deed by the poet who drowned that year, they have a special ceremony. It's called the Awakening of the Dragon in order to provide good fortunes for their crops and their lives that coming year. They have Awakening of the Dragon. And since that time, they've had a Dragon Boat Festival every single year.
Out there, you folks that used to swing dance with each other, and I picked this one up from when we did the swing band gig a year and a half ago at the high school. So great old swing song. If you know how to dance that style, we're gonna give some solos on this one, and you're gonna hear the guys play too.
Hey, go! everybody doing out there? Not too shabby. Are you guys ready for a night of Celtic rock music?
We're ready.
Well, we are the Men in Kilts from Winnipeg, Manitoba. And we're happy to be here, and we're going to have a lot of fun tonight.
You said it, Dan. What a beautiful town you have up here. We were out playing bagpipes on the mountain a little earlier.
Thank you very much, Russell McGoon. For this next one, it's off our first CD that we do after sale here tonight, both. The first one and the last one that we just put out in February. But this one's a little tune called The Scotsman. And it might help to explain a couple of questions that might be on your mind right now. Go ahead, ask the question. What's under the kilt, eh? Boots and socks, boots and socks.
Find my way back home.
You are. You're Travis.
I don't think so.
Okay. You don't think so?
I don't think so.
Oh, all right. That ain't my name. What's your name?
Drew.
Drew.
It's a joke.
Okay.
Get it? Drew.
All right. I can talk slower. That's not necessary. That's not... Okay, so Mr. Drew.
No, Drew's the first name.
What's your last name?
Art. Drew Art.
All right. Get it? It's a joke. Okay. All right, good. Very funny. All right.
So, anyways,
no.
What are you doing?
No, you gotta do me a favor.
What's that?
Do me a favor.
What?
Speak up.
What?
Speak up. Speak up why?
Little ears.
What?
I got little ears. Can hardly hear ya. I want bigger ears.
Okay, I can do that.
All right, if you can do that, that'd be good. All right, get bigger ears.
All right, so if I just do, okay,
that ear there.
All right, right here.
Yeah, that'll do it, right there, that'll do it.
Okay.
Bigger.
Okay.
Little hole.
All right, good, little hole right there.
Earring. Not a hoop.
Okay. All right, not a hoop.
All right, that's not the kind of, okay, the other ear.
All right,
bigger.
Okay, higher.
Okay, down. Up. There we go. All right,
hole. All right, got a little hole in there, so now you can hear.
I'm surprised at the commitment of you people for a one-week single-use festival. You've got it painted on your roads. They went all out, yeah. But they probably charge you an arm and a leg to do it, eh? You want to paint our roads, that'll cost you. I don't care if you're bringing in $100,000 to the economy, you're painting the damn roads. You guys in Manitouwadge, I'm sure you've got a sense of humor. Wow, because there's a lot of you here, and when I drove up, there weren't too many coming the other way. So I know you really want to be here. It's either that or witness protection. I'm not sure. But your secret is safe. Your secret's safe up here. Ventriloquism. Boring! No, this is not a kid's birthday party. No, this is not some kind of... This is Manitouwadge. No, they don't want a lot of thee. No, they don't want some sort of hack. They want a guy who knows what the hell he's doing. No, they're used to people coming up here once, twice, three times a year. And they want to see a real guy. No, if you're a ventriloquist, you just spit in my eye. I did not. You got a squeegee? Listen to me.
As I lie awake, Portsmouth starts to break. My fear of life has found this night to start a thought you've brought to me. I wish this thought could set me free.
How about the ladies? Would you like to hear a love song? That's it? Well, I don't get it, man. 1956, they were all over the stage. Whatever happened? Those days. All right. I'll ask the guys then. Gentlemen, would you like to hear a love song? Yeah. Times are changing, you know.
Just what I would like to see, 'cause I've grown, I've been set free, yeah.
to saying, oh, Shell, you know, a four-hour job. No, no, you'll have a good time, but yeah, a four-hour job. I think they're having a good time now, aren't you? See, did I tell you Manitouwadge rocked? I told you, Manitouwadge rocks. We're going to do another song for you.
Got the radio playing loud, pushing my pedal to the metal, flying down the highway. I am slowing down. The only thing that's on my mind is getting home to you. I gotta quench this appetite and find the faster route. I'm burning up the black tub so I can spend some time with you. I'm burning up the black tub. Baby, if you knew, I can't sleep and I can't think. I'm breaking all the rules. Keep it burning numb and I won't stop. Keep burning up the black tub. Shoulder, couldn't wait for the passing lane. I'm shifting gears and baby, it's clear. Ain't stopping till I find.
Concern about our community. A mine closure is looming. People have been concerned what's going to happen. There's going to be job loss. On behalf of the Economic Development Corporation, I just want to assure you that Manitouwadge will be here well into the future. How can this place not have a bright future when it's got so much going for it? Just think of the air you're breathing. Some people from Windsor will tell you why they're here. It's to breathe this air. Not to mention how serene and quiet and slow-paced the lifestyle is here. I heard one of our new residents call this place the middle of everywhere. It's not the middle of nowhere, it's the middle of everywhere. We've got some of the most affordable housing in the country. People are attracted to low mortgages, you know what I mean? And particularly, people with white hair who are looking for some healthy retirement living in the latter part of their life. And we've got some of our newer residents coming here, and I tell you, there hasn't been two people that haven't been more involved in their community. The McCarkerins are coming in, and they're going to come up here and join me on stage to represent the people that are considering our community for their latter part of their life. Obviously, people are concerned about employment, you know, what kind of jobs do we have here? Well, I'll tell you, the forestry industry is going to move into that leading role for major employer of our community. The logging industry here is alive and active. Yeah. Right on, yes indeed. And Carlos is here, right on, buddy. Okay. I mean, we can't forget the mining. I mean, I know our Newmont mine is due for closure, but I'll tell you, we've got mining contractors that are giving jobs everywhere in town, Manlock specifically, CM&D, Dynatech, they're all employing people here in town. I think we'll have mining around for a long, long time. Are you a little warm waiting out there, Ron? Thanks, buddy. Okay, I have to mention too, these guys, you know, we're not ready for you guys yet. Hang on there, Jordan. Stay right there. I got a little talking to do first. I just wanted to mention the entrepreneurial spirit in our community. I tell you, it's strong. You can go back, way back, to a man by the name of Paul Dallaire, who started working out of the back of his pickup truck. And now he's one of the major employers in our community with a full-fledged welding shop down across town here. That's entrepreneurial spirit, and it flows amongst many in our community. Too many to name. Okay, what are you going to do when you come to Manitouwadge? Well, what is there to do? Oh boy, that's such a big, sorrowful question I hear. Well, I'll tell you, in the summertime, there's mountain biking going on. A lot of mountain bikers around. For sure, and I'll tell you, the way mountain biking is catching on, there'll be more, definitely. We've got an active skateboard community, and I'm sure after Sherry's effort with the Dragon Boat races, we're going to have a skateboard park very soon. Okay, we got, what's next? What do I got? Oh yeah, this, the just the beauty of our area has been mentioned so many times, and if you wander out into the bush far enough, you just might find some happy backpackers out there with their cameras taking pictures of such beautiful scenery that we have around here. Now, there was a major effort put into some research on canoe routes not too long ago. And boy, did they come up with some good stuff. If you're into canoeing, there's all kinds of stuff you can do in your canoe. Trips you can take. There's a big booklet over at the EDC office. If you're interested, you can go over and get a look at it and get some pages photocopied or whatever you need to plan yourself a canoe trip. For sure. The other the big thing to see in our community are the falls. We have four sets of waterfalls here. Manitou Falls, High Falls, Twin Falls, and Middle Falls. And if you need any information on how to get to those falls, you can get it at the EDC office at the town hall or talk to any member of the conservation club. And they'll be more than happy to tell you how to get to see those falls. And I'll tell you, there are some beautiful ones. Okay, well, there's some people that just, you know, don't really want to wander out in the bush anywhere. I can stay around town. Oh, we got golfing, man. We got a beautiful 9-hole golf course here that will offer anybody a challenge. Any golfer, even Mr. Keenan. I've seen him struggle once or twice up there. I want to see your ball. Is it on the roof? No, it should roll off the roof. Okay, yeah, leave that there. That's fine. Of course, we've got a baseball ball association that's active every summer. There's a ball tournament here every third weekend of July for the last I don't know how long. Our pool. We have a swimming pool here. Yeah, we've got a short summer, but we've got a great group of people running the swimming pool with all kinds of activities for young and old. And we've got a couple of lifeguards coming in to represent them. Okay. Most of the stuff you'll notice is summertime stuff. Some people like to get a little bit more rugged and, you know, burn a little gas and whatnot, so maybe finding some ATVers around here. It's starting to really catch on now, so watch out for ATVs when you're out in the bush. Right on. Okay, well, summer activities move into fall activities, and the biggest, most attractive thing for lots of people outside the community is hunting. Moose hunting, specifically. They come from all over the place, man. Come here and hunt the moose down. So, come on up here, bud. Okay, besides that, what do you do in the fall in Manitouwadge? Well, we wait. We wait for snow. We wait. I try to get the kids to do the snow dance. Wait. You know, I try to snap my fingers. That doesn't help much. I tried that a couple of years ago. When the snow gets here, what's the first thing you hear? That's going to get a lot of work going with just the sound of that thing, man. Look at that thing. Right on. The snowmobile industry is a booming industry, and Manitouwadge is in the loop. The Superior Snow Loop Challenge is an active bunch of tourism associations in the area that are providing snowmobilers from all over North America to come and enjoy the trails, and Manitouwadge is a big part of that. What else happens in the winter around here? Well, you don't need too much snow. I see ladies up here already. You don't need too much snow for cross-country skiing. And they're out there with a few inches. And we have a live and active cross-country ski club in town right now, Northern Trails Cross-Country Ski Club. And we have the Kawissa Ski Club, which I happen to be a part of. We've got skiers and snowboarders skiing on the best hill between Thunder Bay and the Sioux. There's no doubt about it. And there's some indoor stuff going on too. We've got a big curling club over there. People like to come out and curl. It's a great game for all ages. And we have an active curling club. And well represented coming in here right now. Okay, so I'm gonna say, what about hockey, Ed? What about hockey and figure skating? Well, of course we have minor hockey and figure skating. Of course. You know? A lot of tradition in our hockey and figure skating programs. Come on up here, you guys. And then Spring comes, in comes the fishing season. Oh, there's a few people around that like to fish. And they come from all over to do that too. So we're here today to tell you, to tell your friends, to tell their friends that Manitouwadge is here and we're strong and we're alive and we're gonna do just fine. We'll be right back.
winter nights, they get so cold. I can stay inside, stare at the fire. I'm slipping on.